All right. This is Mr. Peterson, and it's time for another screencast for our science. In this screencast, we're going to be recorded in front of a live studio audience, and we will be talking about the top two layers of the atmosphere. So let's try to rocket into orbit on this screencast. Next up for layers is mesosphere. Mesosphere is above the stratosphere and starts about 50 kilometers above the Earth. The mesosphere extends to about 80 kilometers. The temperature of the mesosphere will decrease dramatically as you move higher into the mesosphere. It could get down to negative 90 degrees Celsius. And if you remember from the screencast before that the troposphere will decrease as you rise in altitude, then the stratosphere will actually increase, and then once we reach the next layer, which is the mesosphere, it decreases again. The mesosphere also plays an important part in protecting Earth. Many of the meteors that enter the Earth's atmosphere will burn up in the mesosphere before ever reaching the stratosphere. We see them as shooting stars in the night sky. The layer above the mesosphere is the thermosphere. It is the outermost layer of the Earth's atmosphere and starts about 80 kilometers above the Earth and reaches about 200 kilometers above the Earth. The thermosphere is very hot, but you would never be able to tell. It can reach about 230 degrees Celsius. However, the particles are so far apart that you wouldn't even be able to feel the temperature if you could somehow stick your hand out of a plane window that was flying in the thermosphere. If you're not quite sure or understand what I'm saying, it's okay. We're going to have a class demonstration. No, you couldn't really fly a commercial plane up in the thermosphere, but as a point of explanation, I was just trying to get you to understand that. The reason that the temperature increases is because there's no air particles deflecting UV radiation. So this layer gets all of the UV radiation sent from the sun, energizing all of those air particles. The thermosphere has several layers. At the bottom of the thermosphere is what's called the ionosphere. The aurora borealis happens in the ionosphere. Above the ionosphere is the exosphere, and this is where you'll find space shuttles and satellites orbiting the Earth. As you get into the exosphere, temperature starts to drop again because you are now reaching space. This is a graphic to show you the change in temperature as you rise in altitude. You can see the fluctuation in each layer as you rise, in terms of how the temperature drops, raises, drops, and then raises again. Here's another good visual on where things occur in relation to altitude. Feel free to pause it. Also check out the red line, which shows the temperature, the height of Mount Everest in the troposphere, commercial aircraft, even supersonic jets can actually fly up into the stratosphere, but that's a special case. Well, that's it for now. Thanks for watching.